So, again, in case you haven't been doing this, be sure and save your notes in case your computer crashes. We're now going to look at column vectors. So column vectors are the ones that go straight up and down, so we've talked about that. So the character is a semicolon, that's the new line. And so if I type 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, I'll have a column vector. But we have talked about transpose, and that's actually a great way to make a column vector, is to make a row vector and transpose it. So I'm going to go put this over in my notes. Column vectors, neat trick. But I can't spell and I can't do that. Neat trick. So I've got that. Let me see, I'll see, clear it. So I start out with 1 to 4, and then I transposed it and I got 1 to 4 in a row. So, or a column. So column vectors, pretty cool. I can actually create a matrix with rows and columns. I can run them down, and I can create a new line with the new line. I can actually type a new line. So here, let's just do matrices. Matrices. So for A, I can either say, I don't know, some numbers, and then new line and some more numbers, and I'll get a matrix. Or I can say some numbers and then come down here. And I don't know why I feel the need to make them the same, but I do. So I can go like that. And I got the same thing. So if I wanted to make something with three lines, I just keep going. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oops. Like that. So then I've got my 3x3 matrix. You might be excited to know that I can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I can go, just like with the row vectors and the column vectors, like a bazillion different ways to do this. I can say 1, 2, 3, and then I can go 4, 5, 6, and then I can decide for some reason I want to go back to the new line, 7, 8, 9, and it's still going to give me the same thing. Let's see, how else can I do this? I don't know. I can go, 1 to 3, new line, 4 to 6, new line, 7 to 9. You get the exact same thing. If I wanted, I could say 1, 4, 7, 2, 5, 8, 3, 6, 9, and transpose it. I get the same thing. So really, there's just, it's just impossible to limit the amount of ways that you can do this. So it's pretty cool. And then all those ways are kind of put together here. Now, this one's kind of fun. I want you to spend some time looking at this for real, because even if you've programmed before, this is not something that you will have seen before. This is very unique to MATLAB, the way that this works. So I'll give you an idea of the first couple. So I'm going to take these and I'm going to copy them over into my notepad. So, all right. So whenever you're looking at these, you want to think, all right, A goes from 1 to 4. So that means it's going to go 1, 2, 3, and 4. And B is going to go 5 to 8. 5, 6, 7, 8. So if I'm trying to decode what this would be, C is A transpose, B transpose. So it literally means A transpose and then B transpose. And what's neat about this is if you have a block of text or a block of a matrix, as long as the blocks fit together, then it'll work. And really the only way to express that is to just let you play with it for a minute. But go ahead and play around with these. Remember that the semicolon means to go to a new line, and a space or a comma just means to continue along the same line. So please, please, please pause the video and go figure these out, because you're 100% for realsies going to have something like this on the test. Okay. And on the test, you're not going to be able to like code it. So there's going to be parts of the test that are pencil and paper that you're going to want to play with and make sure that this is working. Okay, so let's pretend you did that. So the next, second one, D should actually be relatively straightforward. Back in here. Let me get us some more room in here. So D is going to give me A, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. And then it says go to the new line, and then I go 5, 6, 7, 8. So it's kind of like there's that block, and I go to the new line, and there's that second block. All right. So for E, it's A, which is that block. And notice there's no new line character. I'm just continuing along in the same row. And I put in the 5, 6, 7, 8 block. So my matrix is going to look like 1 through 8 all in a row. Now F is going to be that 1, 2, 3, 4 block. Then the number 932, and then the 5, 6, 7, 8 block, like that. Got it? You seeing how this is coming together? And that's my matrix. It'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 932, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now this one should freak you out a little bit, and if it freaked you out before, now that we've done those other ones, pause this again and try to get it for real. But think about it in terms of blocks, all right? So I have the A, 1, 2, 3, 4. There's my A block. Then I'm going to go to a new line, and I'm going to put in A transpose. So I have the A transpose block. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I'm going to have the B transpose block, which is 5, 6, 7, 8. Then I'm going to have the B transpose block again. 5, 6, 7, 8. And then the A transpose block again. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'll have the B, which is 5, 6, 7, 8, the 5, 6, 7, 8 block. So that looks a little strange. I'm going to take the blocks off, but what you'll have is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 5, 5, 1, 2, 6, 6, 2, 3, 7, 7, 3, 4, 8, 8, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so let's go try these out and see if that's what we get. So I'm going to call this crazy fun stuff. So remember, anytime you do something, you always want to go type it in and make sure your answer's right. But it's going to be. Yes. So there's that. Now let me start with the CLC clear, because that'll make things easier to see what's going on. All right. All right, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That was on our sheet. And then we have here. Here, was that what we had for D? Yep. All right, and then for E, we had all the numbers just straight up in order. Now, notice it says, you're like, but it wraps around. Well, maybe yours doesn't. Mine wraps around because I have such a small resolution on my screen so that y'all can see it better. But this is like literally the different columns. So if I made it a little bit wider, I might actually get six columns on one. Yeah, see how I got six columns on one row now? So it's still six, it's still the eight columns, but it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we expected to see 1, 2, 3, 4, then 932, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's all still one row. I know it doesn't look like it's one row, but it's one row. I can prove to you it's one row because if I transpose it, it'll be exactly one column. So see if that makes sense. I'm going to say that again. I can prove to you that it's one row because if I transpose it, I get exactly one column. Okay. Then for G, I think, yeah, I got the A, and then the A transpose is here, the B transpose is here, and the B right here. So let me show you one that's, try this, see what happens if I say A transpose, B transpose, B transpose, and B. Okay, and see what happens. So if I run that, it's going to get mad. It's saying that it's not consistent. So here's what I'm trying to do, and then we're going to go do it on paper, and I'll show you why it doesn't make any sense. Oh man, I got to make it big again. Alright, so what I've done is I've come in here, and I've said, alright, I'm going to do the 1, 2, 3, 4 block. I'm going to do the A transpose block, and then do the B transpose block, and I'm going to do the B transpose block. And then I'm going to go to the new line and put in B. What's happened? See how I have a hole right here? There's nothing. I can't have a matrix that doesn't have a entry, does not have an entry in every single space. It's absolutely, fundamentally, in no way avoidable required. So that's why I'm getting an error for that guy. So this guy is an error because it's leaving holes in the matrix. So there you go. Make sense? All right, now it might seem really, really silly that we're doing all these like funny things like this, but honestly, these are shortcuts. They're going to be very, very important, and they will help you make your code better. So this really is going to help you become a better programmer. So please trust me, there's a reason why we're doing all this.